Happy freaking Friday, everyone. I'm Tina Marie J. Welcome to my channel. If you like this video at the end, make sure that you press that like button and don't forget to subscribe for more videos. Today is ICOC Friday, which means we're going to be talking about my experience in the ICOC pertaining to a certain topic. And today, that topic is relationships. That could be romantic relationships, it could be friendly relationships. In my case, it's gonna be friendly relationships because, as you guys know, I never dated in the ICOC. Thank God I entered it as a married woman. When I was a member of this church, I had a very hard time making friends simply because of the fact that I never felt like I could fit in anywhere. Majority of the people in the church that I was in was either way older than me or way younger than me, and I had entered as a young newlywed with two kids, and I didn't find anyone that could really relate with me, so I had a hard time finding my place. I think I probably had only one friend who I'm still friends with to this day, and she is still a member, but me and her became really cool, and it was because we were both struggling, so we were told that we should not be friends with each other. I tried hanging out with other people who were in the church, but I always felt kind of funny. I felt like I was trying to force a friendship. It never felt organic. It felt really fake. Like, I was just doing it just because this is what you do. This is what you're supposed to do. You're supposed to make friends with people who are not worldly, who are godly, and that's just how you do things to help you get closer to heaven. Relationships in the ICOC are very tricky because they're one of those things that you look at on the outside and it seems all nice, pretty, and perfect, but on the inside, it most likely sucks. And I like authentic. I like realness. I'm very honest. I'm not extremely filtered. I don't like to hurt people, but I'm very honest. So a lot of people, I guess, didn't really take too well to that. I was honest about things when I wasn't supposed to be, where I was supposed to sound like a Christian. I never really felt like I could connect with people on a biblical level and just on a regular human level. In my last 2 years, when I started to actually make friends in the church, I felt like it was good. I felt like, you know what, it's not the best, but this will do. This isn't too bad. I felt like I was kind of fitting in some way, kind of, sort of. And it felt pretty good. I opened up, I let everyone know who I was, I became more vulnerable, I said yes when I wanted to say no. After I finally left, it really messed me up. So, how can you get messed up when you're in the ICOC or if you're in any kind of religious Bible-based cult? How can that screw you up in terms of friendship when you decide to leave? You can be in the church or you can be a part of religion that is very controlling and open up yourself and become completely vulnerable. And then when that whole thing falls apart and you end up leaving this cult or this religion, you feel like you are kind of lost in the world. You're just like, how the hell do I make friends now? All the friends that I had that were my real friends, I let them go because I thought I had to let them go because I decided to join this church. Or you may leave the church and have a hard time making new friends because you have a hard time trusting people. In my case, I have a hard time trusting people. I've never had an easy time trusting people. I'm not someone who will trust just anyone. You have to give me a reason to trust you. You have to make me believe that you are someone I can trust. That's how it should be for everyone. Plus, I'm a New Yorker, so for me, it's just street smart. You don't just trust anybody. I became so open that by the time I left the ICOC and I left without any friendships intact, I really closed off. Like, it's kind of like a snail shutting down and closing itself off in its shell. It doesn't trust anyone on the outside. Even if you have good intentions, it does not care. It does not want to come out. It's like, no, I'm staying right in here in my little shell and I'm good. That's how I was when I had left the ICOC, and that's how I am right now. But don't get me wrong, that doesn't mean that I don't want to build friendships and I don't want to build relationships. I do. But when it comes to specifically church people or going to a church, I don't feel comfortable being too friendly or just too open with someone there that I don't know. It would take me a very long time to build that trust. And this is something that happens when you leave a cult. You have a hard time trusting people, and it's very normal. So if this is you and it sounds like you can relate to me, don't feel guilty about it. Don't feel bad. Don't feel like there's something wrong with you, because there's not. This is normal. This will be normal whether it's a cult or it's not. No matter where you are, if you put all your trust in a certain amount of people and those same people completely ditch you, you're gonna have a hard time trusting anybody else. Now, if you're someone who was in the church and you were a single and you were dating, maybe you were with someone and you were forced to break up because the leaders and the other brothers and sisters didn't feel that you guys were a good match because you weren't spiritually in tune or whatever crap they told you. Or maybe you're someone who was trying to date, but you're always forced to go on these stupid group dates, which I know they had a lot of those because I've even gone on them with my husband and with some other singles. Maybe you were in a relationship or it didn't work out because that person ended up ditching you for someone else who was more spiritual than you. Whatever it is, I understand that that can be very difficult if you're outside of the church and you're in the real world now and you're having a hard time with building romantic relationships, with getting close to someone. Now you can actually date freely. You don't have to date in a group. Now you can hold hands. Now you can kiss. Now you can cuddle. Now you can go to their house and no one's gonna stop you. I know that that has to be hard because it doesn't take much for me to try and think about how I would feel if I were in your shoes. My advice for you would be to just try your best to take it a day at a time, because honestly, when it comes to situations that are uncomfortable for us because of whatever we've been through in the past, the only thing you can do is try your best to take it a day at a time. Go out there and date when you feel ready. If you feel like you're ready to date, you feel like you're ready to get to know someone, don't go past whatever boundaries or limits that you feel you're capable of accepting at the time, because you need to allow yourself to just adjust and to kind of learn how to date outside of the cult, especially if you grew up in the cult or if you were in it for a very long time or for most of your adult life, then you won't know how to date outside of it. So I just advise that you try your best to take your time. Allow yourself to take your time, because that's also allowing you to grow. Like I always say in all the videos, everything we're going through is a process. When we're going through the spiritual healing, our recovery, this is all a process. Every single stage, every single step. Me trying to adjust to making new friends that I can trust outside of the church, for me that's a process. Being in the ICOC can kind of distort things and confuse things. So it's like you don't know when to hold on to someone or when to let go. And at the same time, you don't want to be taken advantage of. I think that's one of the biggest things that we go through as ex-ICOC cult members. We have a hard time understanding when we should let go, when we should hold on, when we should trust, when we should not, how far we should go, how far we shouldn't go. And this is something that it takes time to get to know and to adjust and learn. So now, where do I stand? When it comes to religion, or someone tells me they're a Christian, that they go to church, I kind of shy away from that person. And I try not to, because I don't want to seem like I'm discriminating. I don't want to seem like I'm putting every religious person into a box, because that's wrong. I do still have friends. Actually, my best friend is still an ICOC member, and I love her to death. That's my best friend. And I would never try to tell her not to remain. But we were friends from way before, so she is already on my level. Like, she understands how I think and how I move, and she accepts me, and I love her for that. But when it comes to other people who are still a part of a church, if a person comes up to me and they're just too friendly, and they seem like they're trying to be super nice and all of that stuff, it kind of makes me shy away, and then I feel like, all right, you know, you kind of got to step back a little, just give me my time. I do have one or two friends who are still in the ICOC. We don't really talk. We've become more Facebook buddies now, and I'm cool with them. As long as I don't feel like they're trying to make me come back, then I'm okay. I can still trust them in some way. I just don't like to feel like people are trying to persuade me or trying to manipulate me, because then the friendship is all off. Like, I can't be friends with you at that point, because then I can't trust you if I feel like you're trying to sell me something. You're trying to convince me and trying to force me to believe in what you believe in. Alright guys, so let me know down in the comment section below. How do you feel when it comes to romantic relationships, friendly relationships? How has the ICOC or any church organization or religion in general changed the way you feel when it comes to relationships? How has it affected you? Also, down below in the description box, if you want to join the Beautiful Souls, everyone is welcome. You don't have to be a Bible basher. You don't have to be an atheist. You can still be a church member, does not matter. Now, if you like this video and you want to see more ICOC Fridays, make sure you subscribe, press that little bell button so you get notification every time a new video pops up. And I love you guys all so much. Thank you, thank you, thank you so much for joining my channel and for watching me. I will see you guys on Monday for our Affirmation Monday video.